Right now, our demand has changed. I'm glad you brought that up because we've kind of experienced a lot of change here in the last year or so, brought on by multiple things in the market have changed that changed us. But to answer your question, all the areas are doing very well. Red River, Taos, Angel Fire, they are all so different. And I will get people, it's funny, they'll call me from your part of the country or other parts of the country, and they're like, listen, I have heard so much about that area. Can you talk to me about houses in the area? And I'm like, okay, which area do you want a house in? Well, I don't know. Tell me about all of them. And I'm like, listen, you got to get in your car and come here because Taos is completely different than Angel Fire, which is completely different than Red River.
Mm-hmm.
They really are. And you'll find something that suits you. That's for sure. Whether you want to be in the hustle and bustle of downtown Red River or you just want to sit in a cabin by a stream all by yourself in the mountains, you can have any of those. Or if you like the culture of Taos and all the art stuff down there, I mean, maybe that suits you better. But there is something for everybody up here, except a beach, I guess. But other than that, we can pretty much fit something for you.
Mm-hmm. What's the supply-demand picture like of available real estate from all those markets? Because I know, just specifically in Red River, pretty limited supply many times.
That's true. We've had a surplus of buyers lately, and our inventory is low. There's no doubt about that. And it has a lot to do with just the market. Right now, interest rates are down. People are starting to rethink what they want to do in life, too. And we get so many calls from people that are like, listen, I live in this town, I live in that town, whatever, and I'm just kind of rethinking a lot of things, and I'd really like to have a vacation property in the mountains. Which brings us to another point, why Red River does well, and a lot of these do, is because these homes have the potential to be income producing.
Mm-hmm.
So these folks can buy that, and I bet you probably 80% of the folks that walk into my office want the ability to be able to rent out their house. So it becomes kind of it's very helpful to them. They're like, not only can we have a vacation spot, we can rent it out and actually make money. And these houses do. I mean, the rentals are good. People come here all the time, and our occupancy rates are just going up and up. I think some of the houses we have available are already booked 100% throughout the entire summer and into next Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a very popular place for people to come rent houses. And if you've got some extra income and you'd like to buy a house and then rent it, you can do it yourself. Or we have a property management company here, and there's a couple others in town, too, that can help you out. So a lot of times it just makes sense for people. But the problem is everybody thinks the same thing, and it just has created a shortage in the supply. Unlike some of the towns like in Colorado, let's say Crested Butte or Aspen or something, as soon as the town started filling up and they started running out of supply, they'd go buy the next 5,000 acre ranch next door and just keep going. Well, Red River is an island. I mean, we are surrounded by national forest, and we're not going to have any more private land. So what that's doing, it's kind of putting a squeeze on our market. I pulled up a few stats, and there's rumors all over about how well this economy is doing and the housing, but when I looked at it, it's like, yeah, we're definitely doing well. I mean, we've kind of started, we've ticked up in our home sales, the amount of home sales. The average price has ticked up a little bit, too. I was pulled up, it looked like the average price in 2019 for a single-family home in Red River was $368,000, and in 2020 it was $399,000. So I've heard rumors that people are going, I heard real estate's doubled in Red River, and I'm like, well, no, it hasn't mm-hmm. doubled. It's still affordable, you guys.
So, right.
But just finding you that piece of property that you want, we've got automated mailing lists, and something will come on the market, and if it's priced right and it's desirable and they can rent it out, sometimes it's only on the market for a couple days.